All right, let's give this indefinite integral a shot. We've got a lot going on here where we have 5x multiplied by e to the 5x power dx. So with this problem, we can't just do a simple substitution to accomplish our goals on this one. Instead, what we want to do is we want to use integration by parts. The formula for integration by parts is over on the right-hand side. But as we get going on this, we don't have a log or a natural log. So as we pick out our u and our dv, we have to be a little bit careful about it. All right, so our u is going to be, we want to avoid that e to the power as being our u. So I'm going to elect to use 5x. Sorry, I put that one in red. So 5x going on with the u, and then the e to the power and basically everything else, all of this is going to go as our dv. So e to the 5x, dv, we'll write it out there. All right, next, we kind of go both directions on this. With our u, we're going to take its derivative, and with our dv, we're going to take its antiderivative. Okay, so for u, the derivative here is du, 1 du, and the derivative on the right-hand side is going to be 5, and we put a dx on that side. Now, as far as dv goes, remember, we're trying to integrate here. So we're going to get a v on this side, and then to integrate e to the, we're trying to find the antiderivative of e to the 5x dx. We're going to have to be a little bit careful on this one that we have a function inside of a function. So we are going to use substitution on this. So typically we use u as being our variable for a substitution method. But in this case, we already used u in this problem. So I'm going to make it w instead. So I'm going to make w our inner function here, the 5x. So we can rewrite. Next, we take the derivative on this side, and the derivative on the other side, we get 5 dx. Well, we can replace the dx in this, but we don't have a 5 as I've kind of sorted this out. So let's move the 5 to the other side. So divide by 5 or multiply by 1/5. That'll isolate the dx on one side by itself. So thinking about v still, we're taking the integral of e to the w power. Right, we can replace in the 5x with w because that's what we let w equal. And then the dx, we're going to replace that with 1/5 dw. Now, typically we put the dw in the back and then we put the 1/5 in front. All right, finally taking the antiderivative here, we'll bring the constant along. And then the antiderivative of e to a power is just e to that power. And I'm going to leave off the plus c for right now. But to finish this up, we're going to replace back in with w equals 5x from the let statement about w. And we'll say that's the antiderivative of of e to the 5x dx. All right, now let's go over to our integration by parts formula and start filling in. So in u spot, we can replace that with 5x. And we can replace v with what we ended up finding at the very bottom there, 1/5 e to the 5x minus the antiderivative, the integral of, we're going to again put v in this spot. So we have 1/5, I'm moving that constant out in front, e to the 5x to replace the v. Now the du, that comes all the way over here on the left-hand side, where we said du is equal to 5, moving that constant out in front, that's going to be multiplied. Dx, we'll put the dx at the end. Now we can do a little bit of simplifying. You'll notice that we have multiplying by 5, and 5 times 1/5, or 5 divided by 5, is going to make a 1. So we're going to have x e to the 5x. Minus, again, over here, we were multiplied by 5 and divided by 5. So those can cancel each other out. Now we still need to take the antiderivative of e to the 5x dx. But you may notice we already did the work for this. All right, this was the exact same work, if we want to highlight it, as what was over here where we took the antiderivative of e to the 5x. So that'll work out being the exact same as what we got at the very bottom here. And you could follow the exact same work to get there, but it's really just repeating the exact same stuff. So x e to the 5x minus 1/5 e to the 5x And then we usually put a plus C at the end here to denote we could have a constant added at the end. All right, hope this helps. When you're picking the U and the DV, that's the most important part of this problem, besides just being careful and taking it one step at a time, getting this formula down and plugging in the stuff that we collected over on the left-hand side, plugging it into the correct place here. Now, this one was a little bit more difficult that we had to do an extra substitution down here to integrate the e to the 5x, but sometimes that's just necessary. It wasn't too bad. So hopefully this made sense as we went through it. Keep practicing these. They get easier, but it really takes practice to get good at anything. See you.